हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ प्रोफेसर विवेक तिवारी फ्रॉम गवर्नमेंट ई राघवेंद्र राव पीजी साइंस कॉलेज बिलासपुर। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस कॉन्सेप्ट इन वीवी डॉट नेट, दैट इज डेटा टाइप्स। दिस टॉपिक इंक्लूड्स इन सेकेंड सेमेस्टर ऑफ पीजी डीसीए एंड द सब्जेक्ट इज प्रोग्रामिंग इन वीवी डॉट नेट। वी आर करेंटली रीडिंग अ सेकेंड यूनिट ऑफ दैट सब्जेक्ट। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट, वॉट इज डेटा टाइप? So, like any other programming language, the definition is same here. That is, the type of data that we are going to use in our program is known as data types. So, VB.NET supports multiple types of data type. Basically, when you try to divide this data type into categories, you can find numeric data type, object data type, date data type, character type, string type of data. So you can divide the types like that, and the decimal data type, you can say that. Now the numeric data type is further categorized into the short data type, integer data type, long data type, single data type, float and decimal data types. So to store a numeric value, this 6 categories of data types are available in VB.NET. Suppose we have to store any number format in our program, we can use short. The IL encoding is int 16, and it takes the size 2 bytes in memory. This data types having some pre-specified range, so according to that range we will use this data types. So if you use integer, then it takes 4 bytes in memory, and the IL type, that means intermediate language type, is known as int 32. Basically, it is all the language that is supported by the .NET will follow the same type system, common type system, and that is whatever the type that you are using in VB.NET. Here integer is used, INTEZER is used, while in case of C#, you have to use only INT to represent integer type. But whatever the type it is, whatever you have write, whether it is in C#, whether it is in VB.NET, after compilation, that will convert it into the IL type, that is int 32. That is very important concept. Now, the third is long, which is used to store the data, which is very heavy in size, in range. Now, to store a decimal value, to store a floating point number, we are having 3 different data types, that is single, double and decimal, having the memory space correspondingly 4 byte, 8 byte and 16 byte. Now to store a character, we are having a character data type, and we are having a string data type, with and the size it takes is correspondingly 1, 2 and 4 bytes. Again, there is a one boolean data type. To store true or false, it takes 4 bytes in memory. There is one date type. To store current date and time, it takes 8 bytes of storage space in memory. And the super class of every other data types is object. In .NET, every data type is a class. In .NET, every data type is a class. And object is a super class of each and every data type. So when we categorize these data types into our programming language, so basically it belongs to the two categories, the value type and reference type. So we will see it later on in our discussion. So let's understand the few important concepts, and that is the character and string data type that I have mentioned earlier will use Unicode formatting. It will use Unicode formatting. The decimal, doubles, singles data type are used to store decimal values, while byte, integer, short, long are used to store numeric values. So these are the categorization of the data type that I have discussed. I have not specified the range the data type can store. So let's understand what is value type and what is reference type. I have told you earlier, the data type in VB.NET can be categorized into two different categories. The one is a value type and the another one is a reference type. So what is the difference between the value type and the reference type of data? So the basic difference is that the value type data type will stored in a stack, while the reference type data is stored in heap. So stack is a type of memory, heap is also a type of memory. बेसिकली स्टिक मेमोरी इज कॉल्ड अ कंपाइल टाइम मेमोरी और स्टैटिक मेमोरी, दैट इज द इफ वी हैव टू स्टोर द फिक्स्ड वैल्यू वी कैन यूज द स्टैक, एंड हीप इज कॉल्ड द रन टाइम और डायनेमिक मेमोरी. इन स्टैक द वैल्यू विल बी स्टोर्ड, दैट आई हैव टोल्ड यू अर्लियर. In stack, the value will be stored, while in the heap, the location or the memory address of the value will be stored. Not exactly the value will be stored, the address of the location, the address or location of the that data type will be stored. So, that is the difference between value type and reference type. Basically, when to use the stack, if there is very small amount of data, then go with the value type variable, stock value type of data type. And that is, if you are having very small amount of data, then use a stack. Or value type. If you are having huge amount of data, then and you have to use reference type of data. So this is the difference between the value type and the reference type variable that we'll going to use later on. And the whatever the variable that have used having the type of data, that is value type or reference type. So it is the basic difference, fundamental difference between the value type and the reference type variable. So now let's see, there are many more functions available in VB.NET to convert one type of data into another type. I'm going to provide a list of functions which is used for data type conversion here, but we will use this all this concept later on in our program. So there is a cbool is a one function which is used to convert any other data type into Boolean data type. Cbyte is a function which is used to convert any other type into byte type. Ccharacter, Ccchar is used to convert any data type to character type. Like this, there are many more functions available in the VB.NET which is used for explicit type conversion. Implicit type conversion can be automatically performed by the compiler of VB.NET. So these are the basic functions for which is used to convert data type in our programming. So I hope this concept is clear to you. So what is data type and what are its types, along with that what are the various functions available to convert your one type of data into different type of data. In this lecture we have understand the basic concept of data types. In another lecture, in my next lecture, we will study about the fundamental concept of variable, how to use a variable. Thank you very much.